And now the wretched box is gone. Mind you, it did say that this is not a toy. Okay, this is for adults. Yeah, right. Oh, go! Yes, again. Wow, the Titanic's actually doing quite well there. Oh, here comes Titanic! Oh, broadsided, totally broadsided by the Titanic!
Warning, this Titanic review shows a ship playing in the pool, and maybe the safest thing to do if you are playing with ships or toys like this in the pool, please remember to remove them before they sink.
Well, hello, this is my review of this rather large and rather beautiful looking Titanic model. It's a remote control model made by Nikita, and it's one of these things that it pulls at your heartstrings, your emotional heartstrings. Anything to do with Titanic, you always think back to the disaster in 1912. I think everyone knows that disaster. There's a bit of a story to how much money I paid for this model. I didn't pay the top dollar, but I'll tell you the story how I got this model cheaper in store. And I'm reading the box there, and it's telling me it's a four-channel remote control. It's got three motors of three propellers, a 700 milliamp hour battery, steering control by servo, whatever that really means, deck details, superstructure, deck illumination, presentation rack, instruction manual, and built-in stern tube. I don't understand that either. The scale is 1 to 325. But overall, the way it's presented in box, it looks fantastic. It's floating on an icy sea. It looks spooky. It looks scary. It looks very Titanic. I'm not even going to try and sound like an expert about this vessel here. It's a very complex subject, and I'm sure there are people out there who've studied it with great interest. I picked up this book. It was on special, down from $45 down to $12, or $12.99, basically $13. It's basically one century later, so what, it'd be 2012 when this book came out, I think, I hope. And I really wanted to take a look at some of the pictures in here because I wanted to see what the ship really looked like when I look at pictures like this here. This is a great example. There's one of the propellers there and the propeller on the main keel of the vessel, and you can just see the rudder there. Whether the model ship that I've got emulates what you see here. Yeah, so lots of things that I learned from looking at this book and reading it. Lots of details in here. I find much more information from books like this. Let's say hopping online and, you know, trying to be divulged there. And seeing the picture here of the life rafts reminds me that was one of the major problems of the ship. The fact it didn't have enough life rafts. But I'll get into terrible trouble showing you that book there. But what I'd like to say is if you see books like this and you see it at the right price, it's very much worthwhile getting things like this. I'll just bring this box forward because there is a curious box read on the top here, and reminded me for the fact it wasn't until the 80s when the ship was finally found and discovered at the bottom of the Atlantic. Let me just freeze frame that so you can have a quick read. The blurb on the top of the box, I'll break it up into two screenshots. You can read it if you want to. There's a few things that I'd forgotten about. It tells you the time scale it went on as well. Mind you, it's talking in 24-hour time, if you can understand that. The amount of people that are on board, the amount of people that lost their lives. Yeah, quite some interesting details there. And I'll go down to the second part of the blurb here. And the blurb continues on there, a bit of an overlap there. It speaks about the James Cameron film Titanic that won 11 Oscars. And the fact that the wreck was discovered in 1985. Huge time gap between 1912 to 1985. And they found out that the ship was actually broken in two. So finding the wreck started to solve the mystery of the Titanic, and some pieces were brought up, artifacts from the ship. I dare say they are more valuable than little pieces of rock that were brought back from the moon. So I wonder how truthful the facts are on the top of the box right there. I'm sure the Titanic experts will explain it to me. Let me show you the artwork on the back of the box. That's what it looks like on the back of the box. Some more info about the model, a nice picture of the model on its display stand. And also another little brief about what the model can and can't do. Well, there's that mini bit of detail there. The first thing it says, completely new tooling. What was wrong with the old tooling? Read along there, see if it spells out right or anything, makes any sense. I'm sure you'll tell me if it's wrong. The top of the box has already taught me it was a vessel that was going between Southampton in England to New York. And I looked at the picture here. And I looked up this mast here, and it's got an American flag there. And if I follow this antenna array here, up the back, I can just see the Union Jack peeking out. I'm not sure whether that's saying to me, well, it came from England here, and it's going to the USA. And I looked at some pictures in this book. I couldn't find the flags like I saw. I think I see a White Star Line flag there, and there's another flag there, which I can't quite tell. I can't show you that book anyway, because I'll just get into copyright strife. I'll come in and unbox this absolutely stunning large remote control model, and I'll probably need to put the camera down to pull this vessel out of the box. Or maybe I can put the camera on a stand and pull it out. I did have this model out last year. I floated it in the pool, but I never powered it up. Ooh, yeah. Making some squeaky sounds and it looks totally amazing. Now the model is free of the box, I can turn the box upside down. There's a whole bunch of constructions there and things I want to read, but because I'm a man, I'm never going to read that. Things like that end up, well, basically straight in the bin like this. See you later. Oh, that nasty box is gone, and I did read on the bottom that this is not a toy. It always makes me laugh, I don't know why. It's got a nice little diorama there at the back, so it looks like the ship's about to get frozen and caught up in the biggest iceberg you've seen in your life. There's other things up here. There's a charger there, the remote control. Oh, too much noise, isn't there? It's there. Oh, that's the map of the world. I thought that was like a ripped off sticker. That's strange, isn't it? The stand, the antenna, a battery there for the remote control, and also the battery for the Titanic. As for the ship, it doesn't take me long to realise, well, obviously I'm not dealing with the top-end, high-end detail that a lot of people who do ships enjoy. This is something more like a fun thing, I think it's the best way of saying it. Mind you, it has been afforded some details like this antenna system, which is a little bit unusual. I think it's called the Marconi Array or something, might be wrong there. There's that Union Jack there, the British flag, but if I run up here, whooshka, up to the American flag, some people are going to start to get annoyed. Obviously someone in China doesn't understand the American flag. I'm just getting the stand out because that's really important with things like this, so I can get the model out of the box without it falling over, because the keel tends to be something that is not inducive for sitting on a bench, if that makes any sense. I think it's a snap thing. Like that. Sounding very plasticky, isn't it? Okay, that's one end. I should do the other one to show you what it's like. Oh, okay. I get the battery charger and battery cooking, so we've got something to play with. This is the remote control. I've screwed the antenna in there. It's your typical cheap and nasty feeling, well, remote control that you'll find on many, many toys. Using the word toy there. Notice that the screw is not there, that is normally for that cover there. Make sure the polarity is right, get the battery in. Once the battery is in, you can then slide this thing back on, and there's no screw, so it'll just get a clip. Notice there is an on-off on this, which is a miracle as well. Yeah, it just really feels cheap, and that there does nothing, it's just a sticker. Starting to get a feel for what this is. I'll come and grab the model, and I will talk about the price of this and how much I pay for it. Oh, sorry for the squeakies, but we want to see sort of what we're getting for our money before I start talking about price. Okay, it has landed. I've just noticed some extra paraphernalia here in the box. Yeah! This document here is a warranty, you know, under Australian consumer law you need that, but it does not cover the use of the vessel in salt water. That's very important to read. And on the flip side of this, and if I get it around the right way, it talks about the duration of the battery packs, and because I've got the 9.6 volt, it's saying 15 to 20 minute running time. Which is sort of what I find with these sorts of toys. And then there is this, that's basically what I read on the bottom of the box, but it's a little pamphlet. And you can go through here and you can understand where to put the batteries and things. What the sticks do in the remote control, you know, what powers what in a sense when you push the stick, safety precautions, and quite a few very funny pictures there that I'll just go through so you can have a bit of a giggle. Maybe I need a set of pictures like that at the start of my videos on YouTube. It'll save me putting up the title and me going warning, warning, boring, boring. There's also pictures here as well. You know, playing with boats on the water can be dangerous. It can also be a lot of fun. It's more fun when it's dangerous, isn't it? Don't put your Titanic on the fire. What happens when you turn the button on to turn the lights on? It looks all spanky. And also advice on if you have trouble shitting. Yes, I'm not joking there, trouble shitting. So there you go, you can now flag this video because I've said the word shitting. And if your Titanic does have any constipation problems, well, this is how you get out of it, mind you. It seems like most of the problems just say change batteries. Well, seeing that there has me curious to how much Chinglish problems there are going on in this manual. Let's talk about how much I paid for this model here. I'm just going to put the box back on the bench. Well, there's the price and a barcode there. It does say Rusco Racing Titanic. Oh, don't tell me this is a racing vessel. $199, but I didn't pay that for this craft. Well, I've scratched on there the retail price and I got 20% off, which is basically $40, and let me explain to you how I pulled that off. I'd like to bore you with the story of how I pulled a discount when I bought this remarkable Titanic model. I was down at David Jones at Chatswood in Sydney. I don't often shop at David Jones. I pick up the Dickie toys quite often at David Jones, and I was down there looking at the Thomas and Friends stock and how it's been diminishing from many stores in Sydney, Australia. I've done a couple of videos about that. It was a post-Christmas sales. My son was with me, and we saw this model, and of course it catches your eye, and I looked at the price. Next thing, I'm touching the box. Next thing you know, I'm buying this thing. I thought it was a bit expensive, and I will discuss how much I think it's really worth soon. And I stood at the point of sales counter for what would have been 15, maybe 20 minutes. It may have been longer. I saw staff people passing me by. I think there's a lunchroom or something nearby, or toilets or something. And I'm thinking, wow, do these people really want to sell stuff here? Or do they want people to walk out of the store without paying? And I thought, wow, if I walked out of the store without paying and I got caught, I could say to the judge in court, well, you know, I did try to buy this. I was at the counter with my wallet out and all the rest of it, but the staff ignored me. Go back and look at the security footage, and I'm sure it would have revealed what was going on. In the end, this quite incredible staffer turned up, and I wish the receipt. I can't find the receipt. It faded like to nothing, the receipt. That's why I scribbled on the box the price and everything and what was discounted. And the staff person who came and saw I was a bit irritated started to fix things up really fast. They said, and she said, how long have you been here, sir? And I said, too long. Okay. And I said, look, I'm really in a rush. I've got to get back to the car park because there's a time limit on the car park, or they start charging you for six. You know, in Australia, there's no incentive to go to shopping centres. They want to charge you to go and park your car. And straight away she said, right, we'll take 20% off this, you know, and all the rest of it. And she's apologised. That was a very important thing to do. I don't care about the discount, but if you get an apology, that's, you know, 90% of the way to make people happier. And in the end, she resolved what was going to be, you know, me being an angry consumer, walking out of the store, probably never to come back again. But sadly, there's many retailers that don't get that. Okay, an apology goes a long way when there's trouble. And I had a bit of a kerfuffle with someone on eBay, and I thought to myself, I don't get an apology. What you get is legal threats. So I'm always going to have more confidence going to a store to buy something than, let's say, buying stuff on eBay. And also on eBay, if there is something going on in the background, the eBay shops can hide all that information and comments that are going up on their site. And that was something, when I saw that going on, of what I was saying back to a seller, and they were just hiding it all away, I thought that's actually pretty evil, and I think that's wrong, because I think people who go shop on eBay, you want to sort of see what the vibe is at that shop. If the person selling on eBay can hide that, that's wrong. I think it was worth telling the story. It may have been a bit of a rant in the end. When I think about eBay, I start ranting. You can also pull a discount if a toy or something has got damaged boxing. I pulled that off at Toys R Us. You'll get a 10% discount. I'll put a Lego minifigure there so you can start to see the scalers vessel. And if we go up the front here, and a very quick appraisal here, I can start to see what we're dealing with. I got some repair work to do. It was like that when I pulled out of the box last year. This mast here is bent over. At least it's flexible. That's one thing. It's got springs there, which are probably set a bit too tight. That's why it's bent over. You can see the chimneys there. I hope they're called chimneys or funnels. I know both people will correct me. The battery goes in here behind the Lego minifigure. And I think it was the fourth funnel or chimney on this vessel that was the faker. I think it was just kitchen smoke or something came out of that. Maybe I'll be corrected. But it's when you start looking at the finer details of this vessel, maybe you'll start to get a little bit disappointed. Titanic was a style of ship that was, in a sense, very long and narrow versus the ships you see today. They've put a yellow stripe down between the white and the black on the ship, which really is quite cheap because it's semi-transparent. And really, that should have been painted on. The little holes in the black area, I believe, are portholes. Whether they're accurate or not, I don't think they are. But what is really missing in that area is rivet details. Titanic had tons of rivets in its real detailing. As for the back of the boat, is that the stern? I hope I'm right there. I think they've got the shape correct, especially the rudder shape. It had a very particular style to the rudder, and this gap here where the propellers are. There's three propellers on this vessel here, and if you look back up here, I think this is like the classic lines of the Titanic is around this area here. But really, it's when you start playing with things, you see things aren't glued on properly, I'm starting to see what I'm dealing with. I just noticed on this walkway here, which is raised up off the deck, is that like a little steering wheel there to control the ship from the back, or am I just dreaming there? The propellers on this vessel, originally I thought they were just plastic, but the more I play with these, I think they're metal, and I've sort of worked that out as well by giving a bit of a scratch. and it sort of reveals underneath there we've got metal. And I know people will be saying, "Oh, Lee, they're called screws, don't you know? They're not called propellers. Propellers are for planes." I will just bend this over because we want to take a look at the keel of this vessel, nice and gently. Okay, I've never seen underneath Titanic. I dare say not many people have, apart from the bottom of the Atlantic. I'm not sure whether that's an accurate rendition of the way this vessel looks on the underneath or the keel area. I'll need my lovely audience to explain that to me. That is my Titanic-loving, lovely audience. Well, I'm under here. I do notice there's a hole there, and there's also another hole right up here. I can only assume that's there for drainage, and I will get Titanic back up on her feet. I'll come in and do a little bit of spot repair work here, just being very gentle with the super glue, and I'll hold in my finger, and I've got another product called Zapper Gap. You know Zapper Gap? It sets super glue off really fast. And I'll also put some glue on that very strange back section, which I thought was a steering wheel. I don't know if I'm right or wrong, and I'll Zap Gap that. Now I'm starting to get a feel for this model and how much it's really worth. How much would you pay for a model like this? Mind you, we haven't seen it running yet. I will get the battery compartment open to take a look at that before we throw the battery in. And what is nice is that you can pull the battery completely out. I don't like charging batteries which are within toys, as that battleship that I had shown last year. So you plug the battery into there. Okay, I've connected the battery up there, and I'll get that tucked away in there, and I can get that piece back on like such. And I can get another little screwdriver shot like that. Titanic has a strange effect on people. It also has a thing which I call Titanic tax. Anything to do with Titanic, they just jack the price up. I think that could be applied to this model here. Let's be reminded of the remote control, you know, generic, cheap. The chargers the same, seen plenty of those. Let's just pull Titanic to the side and be reminded of my Challenger aircraft carrier that I reviewed last year. Pushing Titanic there nice and carefully, and let's bring forward this beastie here. Oh yeah! Yeah, that vessel there, it's been with us I think about 6 years now. Big repair job last year, but it was, hey, worthwhile repairing. And I was so impressed by this that I made a review about this. We had fun in the pool. Hey, the remote control looks like this. It's been hammered. Sort of toy that gets sort of smashed around, heavily neglected in wintertime. I only paid $25 for this. It was on special at Dick Smith and a post-Christmas sale. And I think if I paid, let's say, any more than $50 for this, I'd be paying too much. Its full retail price, Thomas had taken a dive, was $70. Nothing worse than Thomas the Tank trying to steal the show. The only complaints I've got about this toy was the fact it ran around like a speedboat very fast, and it often would run around with a big list on it as well. I think it was weighted up very poorly. Let me just push this to the back here, and we will drag in the Titanic again. Here she comes in the dry dock of my green table. And what I'll do is I'll come in and I'll power up. At least this remote's got a on and off switch. The other one didn't. And there's a button in the front here I've got to push. Okay, I think this is the screws. The middle one's not working there, so I'm pulling it back on the stick. And the other stick is the rudder. Okay, happy to see that. Curious about why that middle screw isn't screwing for me. Looking underneath here, that's pulling the stick backwards. And that's forward. Yeah, and then check the instructions. This is the part I want to look at, and the bottom one going backwards. Oh, okay, only two of the screws work going backwards. As for rudder movement, yeah, do you reckon that's enough? Who knows their ship stuff? And don't forget, we've got lights here. Let's turn the lights off and take a look. Well, it's one of those things. It looks more impressive in real life, the little lights. Very tricky to see properly on video. Maybe it could have done with more areas of light and more portholes and things, but it does make the ship look very spooky. Okay, I got the camera up a bit closer now. We're looking down on the deck there in the funnels. Well, I think the best way of saying it is, well, at least we've got some lights. It would have been pretty boring if it had no lighting at all. Any other question that entered my mind is, did Titanic have lighting like this, like sort of red funnels? Need the Titanic experts back again. Well, really the next thing is to take it for a bit of a spin in the pool. I'll need my son to be the driver of this. I just hope he's nice and gentle, and hope they can sort of coordinate the propellers and the rudder action, so we can steer this vessel in the right sort of way. So up by the pool, and my son is looking over this Titanic model. What's your thoughts about it, just looking at it there?
It reminds me of this movie called The Titanic.
Well done. One thing I noticed was you can sort of tell when it's on and off. If you turn it on, you look down the funnel. There, you can sort of see clearly when it's on and off. I'll just show my son how to turn it on. He's done it for me. This is forward and backwards. And that other one's a rudder. Try the rudder. There you go. It's like child's play. Please don't put this, as in the remote control, in the water, okay? Because that'll be all over Red Rover if that ever happens. Understand?
Yeah.
And now I'm going to come in and launch this vessel. Mind you, it was in the pool last year, but we never powered it up. Just taking it across. Ooh, looks biffo, doesn't it? Okay, nice and gently plonk it in the pool. Okay, see if my son can bring the vessel back to me.
Go backwards.
Backwards, go backwards. Okay, yeah, righto. And it's just bumped into the back of the pool there. Okay, give it some rudder this way, or give it some rudder and go forwards. Okay, well, don't think it's got much of a turning circle. Yes. Okay, try and turn it over here if you can. Is that possible? Yeah, turn the rudder like that and go. None of the controls on this vessel are proportional. Once again, that's very much a budget build. Oh, it's got a bit of a turn, but it's very slow in turning. We get to see just how skinny the craft is there versus its length. What do you think about that one, boys and girls? One thing about this vessel is it looks like that it's actually floating nice and level. It has not listing to one side, unlike that other aircraft carrier I've got. Well, I'm holding Titanic with my hand. I'll ask my son to power up the propellers. Go forward first. Okay, now go reverse. Do some rudder action for me. Yeah. I think that rudder is very inadequate to turn the vessel. Actually, my son has just pointed out to me, leave it so it's neutral. There, I've got to reset the rudder straight again. It must have bumped the pull. Okay, that looks better.
Yay.
Okay, can you please power the vessel up forward, full tilt, and try and get it going as fast as you possibly can?
Oh,
without ramming Rubber Ducky and all the other lovely vessels over there. Well, that's the strangest sort of forward that I've ever seen in my life. Forward, come on, and full stick sideways, try and get it going around the pool as fast as you possibly can.
Mr. Ducky, move!
Oh, straight past Mr. Ducky. And it looks like what we can't turn inside the pool and... Well, there was some backwards there. I don't know. I said forwards! That's the forwards that I want to see. Okay, is that full stick?
Yeah.
Full stick forwards?
Yeah.
Full rudder, try and turn it into the pool. Is it possible that, yeah, he's got a full stick rudder, but we're not turning into the pool. What's that saying to us about this vessel? And there's something you don't see on YouTube every day. I can absolutely guarantee it. The Titanic shoving along a giant rubber ducky. A quite awesome matchbox ship there, but it's powering along okay. Mind you, he's got the rudder going the wrong way. Go full stick forward and turn that rudder. Try and turn it.
I'm turning it.
Sort of doing it now, only just sort of. And going like that, we are going to ram the Lego boat. Boof. Okay, it's gone. The rubber ducky. Boof. Well, I can see one inadequacy is basically this pool here is far too small for this vessel. It needs a much larger thing of water, really, I think, to show its style. It's got a very, very large turning circle. Maybe to ramp up some craziness, I'll just add this Russian aircraft carrier, my $25 special. Yeah. And, of course, there's going to be action like that. Yeah, battle boats in a very different way. Oh, go! Yes, again, wow, the Titanic's actually doing quite well there. But watch out, the Russians are coming, the Russians are coming. Oh, here comes Titanic! Whoa, that was a massive hit! Oh, the Russians are really taking a blow and they've taken off. In fact, the way that my son is driving that vessel, it's quite evil. This Russian thing's, I've just got into a whole ton of trouble. I'm trying to get out of trouble. I'm having trouble with the Russian thing. Come on, wake up, Russian thing. Well, actually, it might be sinking. Oh, here comes the Titanic for another. Oh, just missed there. Okay, I've got power back again. Oh, okay, this is actually a lot of fun. Oh, the Russian Navy. Nice tight turn on that. I can get versus... Oh, I can get the Titanic. No, no. Just missed out there. I've just lost power again. There's something going on there. Oh, no. The Titanic again. Oh. Oh, okay. I've got power. I think the battery's actually a little bit weak at the moment in this Russian vessel. We're trying to get away from the Titanic. Oh, no. I've lost power again. Oh, here comes Titanic. Oh, broadsided. Totally broadsided by the Titanic. Well, maybe forget about this vessel being anything like a scale model and beautiful representation of Titanic. It's more like a...
battle boat Titanic.
Yeah! Russian Navy's been given orders to sink the Titanic. Oh, yes, I think I've got to go here. Oh, I've just come in behind there. And maybe the door can go around the Titanic. See, I've got a much tighter turning circle there. And the Titanic is going to try and chase me, but I can turn tighter than it can. Oh, I'm going to come around and get the bar! Yes! Oh, I finally got a blow to the Titanic, yeah! Oh, but watch out, the Titanic is menacing there. I can go backwards, I think. I've lost control again. Oh, now I've got... Oh, I can go! I've just touched it there. This is a ton of fun. Oh, no, the Titanic! Oh, it's just got me! It's just got me! The rubber ducky's looking on like a dumb duck. It's not even helping me. I've got to get out of here. Full stick forward, full stick forward! Oh, it's really latched onto me there. Oh, we're spinning right around. This is more fun than I ever imagined. I love doing this. Whoa, boff. Oh, I've lost control. Oh, I've just been smacked out by the Titanic again. Wow. Oh, no, I'm backing away. Okay. Full stick forward. Can I get away from this damn Titanic, which is killing me? Oh, it's coming in again. Oh, I can't believe this. Oh, no, even the rubber duck is being taken out by that Titanic there. Okay, I've got full stick forward. I think the battery pack in that may need some more attention. Oh, I'm going to get the Titanic. No, no, it's got me. Can't believe it, can you? Whoa. Oh, I'm trying to power out of here. And, oh, no, Titanic is right on my tail there. I'm starting to lose light as well. I'm trying to get away from this thing. This is a menacing ship. Wow, I never knew it'd be quite so evil. And I'm actually starting to get away from it now. Only just... I'm trying to get in a position to try and get the Titanic. If I reverse now, maybe I'll get it. I've lost power again. What is going on? And because I've lost power, look who's coming. Oh, just missed the back of me, but it glances off. It's bouncing back. That's going to come back for another stinger. Oh, here it comes. Full stick. Oh, man, it nearly sunk me. I can't believe this. Come on, I want my propellers to go. Oh, I've got power again. Oh, no. I never saw that coming. I can't get... And I've, oh, what is going on? And the shark's no help at all. And I'm pretty sure the Titanic's going to come back for another ram. I'm trying to get out of there. Oh, here it comes. Oh, no. I can't believe it. It's been fun as a battle boat. Oh, I'm just so, well, I'm starting to get quite destructive now. And I'm starting to realise that really this is more of a battle boat than anything else. It's a fantastic thing to just run around and ram into things. Oh, looks like it's now after that Lego boat there, but it's just missed. Whoa! That was a smack, and somehow that little Lego minifigure survived that. I don't know how. One of the Lego floats actually broke off on that impact. But I tell you what, I was getting quite, I would just say is the right word, I was starting to get a bit disappointed about Titanic, but I'm actually starting to see that in this style of play, it's actually a whole ton of fun, but I keep losing power, and because I lose power, guess what happens? Ah! The Titanic comes in for a ram. It's just a giant ramming vessel, that's really what it's all about. Oh no! Whoa, that was quite a slam dunk, and I'm starting to lose light here. And I'd really like to get my Russian vessel back up to full power, or else it's going to get assassinated by the Titanic. Oh. And yeah, it seems to be really the best fun you can have with that vessel there. Oh, I can get a little bit of power back. Can I get one stinger in before I leave this video? At least give me a stinger! Oh, just a slight tap next to nothing. There's just one last thing I'd like to do. Let's give a bit of a wave test to Titanic and see if it actually sinks. What do you think?
Yeah.
Because, well, we sort of know that Titanic's prone to sinking. We're just going to set Titanic to the middle of the pool there, and we're going to use this rubber duck here to make splashes. Okay, start splashing, little duck, and let's just see what happens here. The moment they're not really broadsiding the vessel. It looks like it's doing okay. I know Lego vessels can go under with a few splashes going on. Come on, we need more than that. We need bigger. Here's something a bit bigger. Rubber ducky wasn't doing it for me. Mind you, that rubber ducky's big. Use that to make splashes in the pool. Okay, we're going to try and do some nice splashes here. Start splashing away, please. Get some wave action going. Ooh, it's more intense now. I'm trying to sink this Titanic. There's some other vessels in the pool here which may go under all this. Ooh, it's starting to get very rough. It's actually doing quite well. I can't see it necessarily going under yet. It's actually doing quite well indeed. Yeah. Yeah, it's coming over this way. The other vessels are getting... Yeah, well, it's not, put it this way, it's not going under. And that's very un-Titanic of it, isn't it? The fact that it's still floating. Actually, I've spoken too soon. Ah, it's gone! It's gone! It's gone! It's gone! It's done a true Titanic. It's actually totally sunk.
What?
Oh, no! I can't believe
it. I'm soaked, you know, so I can get in there.
No, you... I wonder if the remote control still works. The matchbox boat has survived and often does. The Lego boat has gone over. Rubber ducky's gone over as well. And the Titanic is looking extremely eerie underneath the water there.
Dad, it's so cool when it sinks.
And it's so very, very Titanic.
Yeah.
I'm just going to give it some power forward. I'm not getting any signal. Oh, actually, yeah, it is. I'm getting signal down there. But it's not moving. It's obviously it's too heavy. Do you think you can raise the Titanic?
Yeah.
Okay, try and reach it. Okay, being very careful where you grab it from, because bits will fall off this very easily. Being very careful. Okay, bring it up. Bring it up nice and slowly. Nice. It's quite heavy, isn't it? Yeah. Oh, wow. James Cameron would have loved that shot, I can tell you. That's what he's been wanting to do for a long time.
Dad, I'm having trouble.
Okay, I'll come in and give you a hand.
It's sinking.
Oh, wow, it's like Land of the Giants, isn't it? Oh, man, this thing is, yeah, it's really heavy with water. I'm having trouble myself. Oh, okay, just try and get the water out of this thing. Well, I've got it to the edge of the pool here. It's like having remote control contortions. If you take a look at the rudder there, or listen carefully... Yeah, it's got problems. I think sinking like that is going to be one of the worst things that happened to this model.
Dad, can I see it sink again?
You're a glutton for punishment, aren't you? It looked very cool when it sank, didn't it?
Yeah.
Oh, he wants to see it sink again. I dare say there'd be many in my audience who want to see it sink. Let's just study. No, don't make any waves. Let's just study the way that this went down. Is it indicative of the real vessel? And there's a conspiracy theory about the way it sank for the fact that there was a fire... And the coal and the fire had weakened the steel, and that had let it rupture when the iceberg had hit it. Now, is it starting to go down, or have we sort of hit some sort of equilibrium of floatiness there? I think I saw real trouble when I saw water get up past this point here. I can hear the remote control doing weird things at the back there. We're not touching the remote, but I can hear it making some very strange sounds. My son's going to tease some water onto the vessel there. Is it the bow or the front?
Yep, it's the front.
Okay, well, is it the bow or the stern? Okay, that's enough. Yeah, just see what happens now. Yeah, it's one of these things that when it goes very fast. Okay, let go of it now. Let go. Okay, just leave it like that. Let's just see what happens, because it actually replicates what the real vessel does. Yeah, and we'll try and analyze what happens when it goes. Yes, the bow of the vessel, it's starting to go. It's starting to go, and it's very slow at the moment. Oh, here we go.
Oh,
it's about to go.
It.
Yep, here it goes.
Doing it.
Oh. Watch this very carefully. Wow, it is spookily like the way we saw it on the movie. Oh, and the sounds as well. Very, very spooky seeing that. Extremely spooky.
Oh.
Dad, it just looks like the movie when it sunk, except the part when it snaps.
Well, this model didn't snap, but it looked spookily like the way Titanic sank.
Yeah, because, like, they're supposed to be, like, two bits which are very heavy. When the boat sinks, it snaps because both sides are too heavy. Just like two boats hit together and then they both sink.
Yeah. So you had to play this Titanic. How do you rate it?
1,000,000,000,000 out of 10.
Why? Because of the way it sinks?
Yes.
I thought so.
Rightio, I have a very good feel of what this Titanic model is about, and I've also worked out that it sinks once and I don't think it's going to come back to life. I'm having a lot of trouble getting this model to restart. The retail price in Australia I saw it for was $199. I got 20% off, so my buy price ended up being $160 Australian, or relate that to US dollars, it's basically $122. Okay, US dollars, $122. Now, how much do I feel this model is really worth? And I'll be quite honest here, I would say roughly 80 Australian dollars, or let's call that 60 US dollars. Of course, I've wandered over to eBay to see how much people are selling this model for, and all I could say is just be really careful how much you pay for this model. Remember, there is the price there, then you whack the postage on top of that. I think the people who are selling it there on eBay are way overpricing this model for what I see in this review. I know my audience will have their 5 cents to say about this. I've tried to be as truthful and honest as possible about this model. Yes, it is impressive when you see it in box and all the rest of it, and you can write up some amazing details of what this vessel has, but in reality, you're dealing with something that is just dressed up and propped up just because it's Titanic. When you strip off the Titanicness of this model, you're dealing with a very cheap build, which is actually very disappointing. And I'm always going to ring that bell, buyer beware. You have to be really careful how much you're paying for this model, especially considering the prices that I'm seeing on eBay.
Well, look at that. The Matchbox submarine and squid is there. I'm just going to reach down and try and get the Titanic. Is it caught up in that or not? It's one of the better toys that we've had. And I'll just grab... The problem is, it is so heavy when it's full of water. Okay, and then I've got to, like, get it to the... Just leave it there, yeah. And we've got to try and... get it out. Oh. Once again, that is James Cameron's dream, seeing that, and it's probably never ever going to happen. Well, I think I've got to try and save this Titanic and try and get the water out of it, because I would like to do another video about this, hopefully in a larger pool. Mind you, it is sort of fun doing battle boats. Maybe I put it on its side like that. The water is going to drain. I can still hear water sloshing around inside there. Well, the bad news at the moment is I've lost all the remote controlness and even the rudder as well. It's not a good sign. Well, who would have ever thought that Titanic, the magnificent Titanic ship, would sink on her maiden voyage? Certainly not me. Considering what I just witnessed, you could add another feature to this Titanic model here. You could strip in here, realistic sinking action. Actually, seeing that, it's going to have some people upset. It might be a one video wonder, that thing there. Anyway, we have come to the end of our video. I don't like saying thanks for watching and bye for now. Do you have something you can invent for me very quickly?
Yeah. Thanks for watching. Give your eyes a rest and play with your Titanic.
Thank you. That was very nice.